Arohi, and today on Sciency Soup, let's talk about masks. I'm not talking about these. I'm also not talking about these. Yes, you guessed it right. By mask, I mean the anti-pollution masks. Why and how you should wear these masks? How efficient are the different types of anti-pollution masks? And what are the options of masks available in the Indian market? We are all aware of the rising level of air pollution that have become an annual event in India. Every year, the pollution levels are going off the chart, not just in Delhi, but in many other cities in northern India. I won't talk about the statistics because you have probably heard of them several times in the news. The problem is, in spite of knowing the alarming data, many of us are still not aware of the serious consequences of this issue. And that is the reason why the majority of people in highly polluted cities are seen not wearing any masks to protect themselves. Even those who are wearing the mask are either not wearing the right type of mask or they are not wearing the mask in the right way. See, there are many different types of masks and each type has a different purpose. But before I begin with the type of mask, we need to first understand the particle size of some common air pollutants. When we talk of air pollutants, we often hear of the terms PM2.5 and PM10. The numbers 2.5 and 10 refer to the size of these particles. To keep things in clearer perspectives, I'll make a simple comparison using hairs. The thickness of a single strand of our hair is about 100 micrometers. PM10 are particles less than 10 micrometers. And PM2.5 are particles less than 2.5 micrometers. So you can imagine, these particles are so tiny that you could roughly put 10 PM10 particles or 40 PM2.5 particles on the width of your hair. PM10 include dust, pollens and molds, while PM2.5 include all types of smokes, emissions from vehicles, fine particles of metals and organic compounds. These tiny particles float in the air and when inhaled, they can penetrate deep into our lungs and cause serious health issues ranging from lung impairment to even lung cancer. Now, let me take you to my storyboard to see what are the different types of masks available in India and how efficient each one is. These are some of the most common masks that are being used as air pollutants. All of these masks can protect you from dust and allergens. But when we talk of air pollutants, the main problem is about PM2.5 and PM10 particles. So let's see which of these masks can protect you from PM2.5 and PM10. First, take the example of cloth masks. These are the most affordable and commonly used masks. If you are currently using these masks in a highly polluted area, I'm sorry to say these masks are good for nothing. They'll only protect you from dust and allergens. After the cloth masks come the surgical masks. These are the ones that are used by the surgeons. As intended, these masks can protect you from some airborne infections along with some dust and allergens. In fact, all the following masks can protect you from germs. Surgical masks are quite cheap, but they'll definitely not protect you from PM2.5 and PM10. Next come the N95 masks. These masks can easily filter 95% of all PM2.5 pollutants and 100% of all PM10 pollutants. These can be reused for up to 2 to 3 days and will cost you around 100 to 150 bucks. Several brands are selling these masks. If you want to buy one, look for NIOSH N95 on the packaging. Then there are N99 masks, which offer a protection against 99% of all PM2.5 particles and 100% of all PM10 particles. Each mask is reusable for up to 5 to 6 months. It will cost you anywhere between ₹1,500 to 3,000. Again, for these masks, look for NIOSH N99 mark on the packaging. On the higher end are P95 masks, which are equally good for PM10 and PM2.5 particles. Their downside is that they can only be used once for about 8 hours and are therefore quite expensive. They cost around ₹10,000 for a pack of 10 masks. Their advantage over N95 and N99 is that they give an added protection against oil-based pollutants. So these are the main types of air masks and some of their specifications. Now let's go back. The main problem with using any mask is that some people find them suffocating. And if you are using them for a long time, carbon dioxide and moisture builds up inside. To overcome this, these days, many masks come with a carbon filter that removes any foul smell and a valve that helps in exhalation. Such masks come with a CV mark on them. These masks make breathing a lot easier because there's no moisture retention or foul smell. Apart from the most commonly used masks, there are some innovative masks that are being made in India. Two honorable mentions are Prana mask and nasal filters. Both of them are equally efficient in filtering out PM 2.5 and PM 10 particles, and neither of them use the conventional P series and N series masks. Prana mask is a multi-layered mask that uses HEPA filters. Its speciality is that it is claimed to be India's first motorized air mask. It uses its motor to run a fan that circulates air inside the mask and thus prevents suffocation. Nasal filters are developed by a group of IIT Delhi alumni. Their speciality is that they are not actually masks but are very tiny filters that you can stick to your nostrils. These are by far the most comfortable and easy to use protective gears against pollution. Plus, they are quite cheap. So, clearly there are so many options of masks available as there are a lot of companies selling their anti-pollution masks in India. Buy your mask from a trusted seller and look for the certifications of the mask on the packaging. You should at least go for an N95 rating. And a big no to cloth masks and surgical masks. If you don't like to wear masks because you feel suffocated and claustrophobic, go for masks with CV mark on them. Make sure the mask fits you properly. A loose-fitting mask is of least use. Also make sure that you carefully read the instructions given on the mask packaging. Use the mask only for the specified time period and reuse only if recommended. If the air quality index is extremely high in your city, it is highly recommended that you stay indoors. But if you cannot refrain from getting outdoors, you must wear suitable anti-pollution masks no matter what. I know some people don't wear these masks just because of aesthetic reasons. So, if you are one of them, forget about the shame. You must wear the mask just for the sake of your own health. And hey, there's a very important point that I want to make here. Wearing masks outdoors and installing air purifiers at your home and in your cars are short-term solutions for an extremely serious and bigger problem. It's a shame that we have come to a point where we need to use artificial tools to breathe in fresh air. We all need to educate ourselves and work together towards reducing pollution at source. A well-aware public holds the power to make reforms in public policies on various such issues that have a direct impact on all of us. I hope this video made sense. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. If you intend to buy a mask for yourself, you can check out some links given in the description below. Subscribe and press the bell icon to get more such science-based informative videos. Bye for now, take care and stay curious.